Hello students, welcome to one of the most interesting chapters in your 10th standard history textbook, that is First World War. In this particular module, we will be studying about the age of conflicts. Now before we start this chapter, what does unit 2 of your 10th standard textbook talk about? It talks about 20th century age of conflicts. A lot of conflicts happen. What are conflicts? Conflict is nothing but a clash or a fight, and eventually a war in terms of history is what we call it. So 20th century age of conflicts. Now before we start with the chapter World War, let me explain the timeline of the entire 20th century age of conflicts, which will help us understand the term history better going forward, right? So there's a timeline. The first major event that happened was in the year 1914 when World War I started. This First World War ended in the year 1918. Between 1914 and 1918, another major event in history broke out in 1917, and that was the Russian Revolution. Once the war ended in 1918, lot of efforts for peace began, right? So in the year 1920, an international organization was formed to establish peace in the world, and it was called League of Nations. Eventually, it didn't prove to be very successful. 1922, a violent ideology rose in the world. It was called fascism. So rise of fascism happened in 1922. Similar ideology came up in Germany in 1933, rise of Nazism. And eventually all these violent ideologies led to another world war, which started in 1939, where World War II began. And finally, this war ended in 1945, which led to another international organization being formed, which was known as United Nations Organization. So if you ask me, what does this represent? This represents chapters of Unit 2. Your 2A talks about World War I, 2B talks about Russian Revolution, 2C talks about League of Nations, 2D talks about rise of dictatorship in Europe, where we learn about Nazism, fascism, and other features. And finally, 2E talks about United Nations Organization. So let's not waste any further time and start with our first chapter, World War I, that is 2A, first chapter of Unit 2, right? Age of conflicts. As we've already seen, what is a conflict? A conflict is a clash or a fight. These conflicts in the 20th century, they had certain positive dimensions and they had certain negative dimensions as well. Now, what were the positive dimensions? Now, first and foremost, what are dimensions? Dimensions are nothing but aspects. So what were the positive dimensions? Lot of new inventions happened, right, in the 20th century on account of Industrial Revolution. For example, we had the airplane, which was developed for the first time, invented for the first time. Man could fly from one place to another. How did this come about? It came about because of a very simple reason: progress in science and technology. Lot of changes happened, lot of developments happened in science and technology, right? Not only that, destruction of despotic reigns. What are despotic? Despotic means cruel or unjust, and reign means rule. So many despotic, many cruel, many unjust rules of the world came to an end. Right? Example, Tsar Nicholas II. He was a very cruel ruler, and his rule in Russia came to an end through the Russian Revolution. Right? There was spread of democracy, very positive aspect. Democracy is nothing but government of the people, for the people, by the people. Many people realize that we do not want the kings to rule us anymore. We the people, we will rule ourselves. And that is how democracy came about in many countries in the world. And not only that, experiments in internationalism began. What do you mean by experiments? Very simple. Countries met at international level to discuss peace, to discuss progress, to discuss development, which was never the case earlier. Earlier, the countries only knew to fight. But after the age of conflicts, countries realized that fighting each other doesn't give much. Let us work with each other and contribute for the development of this world. But as we are aware, every coin has got two sides. If there are positive dimensions, of course, there will be certain negative dimensions also, right? Experiments in internationalism. For example, League of Nations was formed in 1920. United Nations Organization was formed in 1945. Now, my dear friends, every coin has two sides. If there are certain positive dimensions, there will be certain negative dimensions also. Use of destructive weapons happened in the 20th century. Atom bombs were thrown in Japan, Hiroshima, Nagasaki. Generations were destroyed together. right? Rise of dictatorship, one of the most cruel forms of government, where a person or a party decides to run a country by their own terms, just or unjust, which causes a lot of trouble for the people, right? Rise of dictatorship. Nazism came about. Nazism was nothing but an ideology founded by the Nazi party, led by Adolf Hitler in Germany. Similarly, there was fascism. Fascism was nothing but ideology of the fascist party, started by a person called as Benito Mussolini in Italy. So if you notice, dictators came up in the world. Germany saw dictatorship. Italy saw dictatorship. Things were looking very bad. And all these dictatorships eventually led to what? They led to a lot of conflicts. Lives were destroyed, properties were destroyed, and eventually a whole loss to the entire world. So these were the positive and the negative dimensions of the war. Right now, when I talk about the First World War, or when I talk about any war, usually a few questions pop up to our mind. What are these questions that pop up? First question is, when did the war happen? The First World War happened from 1914 to 1918. Second question is, where did the war happen? See, World War means happened across the world, but what was the epicenter? What was the central point? The central point was Europe. That is where it all started, it all originated, right? Next question is, between whom did the war happen? Originally, two groups were formed, that is Fergia. Fer represents France, England, and Russia, right? So as you can see on the map, France, England, and Russia. These were three countries which were in one team. Versus we had Germany, Italy, and Austria. This is how it all began. These two groups were supposed to fight each other initially. So remember, Fergia, France, England, Russia, known as Allied Powers, and Germany, Italy, Austria, known as Central Powers. And the most important question, why did the war happen? And that is where we will be studying the causes of World War I.